Welcome to Codebreakers. I want to start by saying God loves you. God is interested in your well-being. He cares about you. He cares about what you are going through. And I know many of you watching, you have a financial need. And you're wondering, Lord, how are you going to come through for me? I need a breakthrough. Now, you're about to see a clear display that God reveals secrets to humankind, to his prophets. God reveals secrets to us. Something amazing has happened in the last few days, and this is why I really want you to pay attention. Multiple events in multiple regions have suddenly intersected in the last week, and they all connect with prophetic words spoken years ago. And why is that important? Frankly, because if there are this many signs coming forth, we need to pay attention, because quite possibly it's an indication that we have an opportunity to do something, to be a part of a blessing. And I also want to encourage you, please watch the whole segment right now, Codebreaker segment, because I do not want you to miss out on a single prophecy that we're about to show you, because you need to know everything that's been prophesied so that you can then take it before the Lord and figure out what God wants you to do. All right? March 13, 2013, I was doing a Codebreaker segment, and Kim had one of those moments where he suddenly interrupted me and he started to proclaim, shout, 20,000. Actually, he didn't even know what he was talking about at the time. Watch this prophetic word. Go.
20,000. I'm hearing 20,000. 20,000, it will reach sooner than most people will think. I didn't know what 20,000 is. All I heard was 20,000. It shall get to 20,000, and some shall say, well, it'll take years and years. Spirit says, no, it won't. It'll be sooner than most people think. It'll be a shock. 20,000.
20,000. Of course, we know now it was in reference to the Dow Jones, what's taking place in Wall Street. This headline happened on January 25th. Wall Street Journal, Dow closes above 20,000 for first time. CNN had this headline on the same day. CNN, boom, Dow hits 20,000 for first time ever. So that moment that Kim saw, he prophesied it. We are now in that moment. Dow 20,000. This historic milestone leaves the Dow up more than 1,700 points since President Donald Trump's victory in November. The achievement is evidence of how optimistic investors have become about the prospects of the U.S. economy. Many feared a market crash before the election if Trump upset Hillary Clinton. Instead, Wall Street has embarked on a very impressive post-election rally that has carried the Dow above 20,000. So you might be like me, where this is the unique side of me that's in all of us, actually. We like to analyze. Predicting Dow will reach 20,000, in my opinion, is not groundbreaking, because eventually the Dow will reach 20,000. But what you're about to see is how I'm going to connect that prophetic puzzle piece with other prophetic puzzle pieces and make you realize what's taken place in the last week is so vital that you pay attention. It will amaze you and quite possibly give you direction on how you should proceed with your investments. Dow 20,000. I'm going to show you this headline. Well, first I'm going to play you the news from CNN. January 26th. The very next day, within a 24-hour time period of Dow reaching 20,000, this news came out regarding California. Go.
It's no secret California has been in a major drought for the last several years. Month after month, a below-normal rainfall has led to the problem and only made it worse. Until now, for the first time ever, California is finally out of that exceptional drought category. Look earlier in the month, January 3rd, 2017, 18% of the state was in exceptional drought. 38% in extreme. Fast forward just 2 weeks and you can see only 2% of the state in that exceptional drought. And then January 24th, the day, 0% in exceptional drought, the first time since January 2014. This is huge to finally have this area out of exceptional drought. So how did we get here? Basically, we have had this river of moisture pumping in from the Pacific, and it has brought storm after storm to California.
Storm after storm to California. CNN had this headline: California's drought is almost over. This is a headline that took place on January 26, 2017. A series of potent winter storms has lashed Northern California and now recently Southern California and has erased the worst of the long-term drought that has plagued the Golden State for 3 years. This took place this week. Dow 20,000, within a 24-hour time period, this news about California and the drought being almost over and certain designations, specific levels of drought being erased officially this week. Now, this is the fun part. How do they relate? How do they relate prophetically? February 22nd, 2014, Kim had a prophetic word regarding a future leader of America. And at the time, of course, he prophesies in code, right? We all prophecies in part, we know in part, we prophesy in part. But he prophesied in code about a future leader of America. And he said, I heard the word gold, something attached to his name, which of course we know now, the president is Donald Trump and his signature is the gold signature. All the signs of his hotels, whatever property he owns, it's gold. Kim talked about gold in this prophetic word. Then he talked about California and the drought being over, being a sign. You are dying, California, because of a drought. Watch my sign. Watch the sign of rain. And in this prophetic word you're going to see, he talks about 20,000. Think about it. Three events prophesied over various times. These three events all took place this week. The Dow reaching 20,000, California and the rain coming down, all happening in the first week of this new president entering office. Is it a coincidence? There's no Hebrew word for coincidence. Watch this word from February 22nd, 2014, so you can understand what do all these signs mean and how it relates to you. Go.
And then I heard gold. I wasn't sure if this was attached to his name, but he said to me, he will restore the fortunes in this nation. Because of his brilliance, I couldn't quite see his face because that was not allowed, because there was a mist that covered all the people and he was amongst them. And the Spirit of God made me look at him and he said, this man will throttle the enemies of Israel. Now hear me please. The giant of death, the giants that have come, the brothers of Goliath, stand in glee watching America. We will cripple you. You will lose your credit. But God said, watch. I said 20,000. Look not to Wall Street. However, observe. And they shall say, what is your plan for this giant? And he will take a simple stone. Remember the name. And he will hold it up and they will laugh at him. But the plan is so brilliant, says the Lord. It could only have been given by me. Come on! California, you are dying because of a drought. Watch my sign. Watch the sign of rain. For I told you there would be severe wind from above. And all the states that are affected by this severe weather have been set up for a shaking of my spirit and an outpouring of my spirit. But California, I'm looking at you.
Amazing. Truly amazing. He prophesied February 2014, gave clues, 20,000, California rain, a new leader in America, and he talked about gold. And we have seen all this prophesied in code back then. We are seeing all this manifest now this week. We cannot ignore this time we are in. We cannot ignore this day we are in. The waters are stirring. Quite possibly, God is trying to get our attention. I don't think possibly he is. So let's pay attention. Let's roll up our sleeves. Let's figure out how should we respond? How should we receive what God wants to get to us? That's what it's all about. So if we saw these signs this week, what has been promised in this prophetic word? Kim prophesied, as you saw, he will restore the fortunes in this nation. This man will throttle the enemies of Israel. So we're about to see something take place in that region. This man will throttle the enemies of Israel. The giant of debt. How many of you out there are in debt? The giant of debt. The giants have come, the brothers of Goliath. They stand in glee watching America. We will cripple you. You will lose your credit. But God said, watch. I said 20,000. See, 20,000 is a sign. It's not just a number reaching it. It's all about timing. It's a sign of the times we are in, of this week that we're in, of what we have just entered into. If there's a calendar that goes from December 31st to January 1st, we celebrate it. We're in a new year. Well, I'm trying to tell you something prophetically has happened and the prophetic calendar has just turned. The signs are here. It's happened this week. Pay attention and find out what God has for you. California, you're dying because of a drought. Watch my sign. Watch the sign of rain. All the states that are affected by the severe weather, in reference to a drought, have been set up for a shaking of my spirit and an outpouring of my spirit. We are ready to receive the Holy Spirit. It's a sign. God wants to pour out the Spirit, and he's going to specifically pour it out on these states, including my beloved California. Amazing. I'm so excited, and I know you are too. Now, let's add to this another prophetic puzzle piece spoken on November 22nd, 2013. I'm just going to read it in an email alert that Kim had sent out to all of us. He said, stated as follows. The Dow at 20,000 points. This is November 22nd, 2013. The Dow at 20,000 points. All of this connects to a massive breakthrough with regard to the dinar. Very interesting. I feel it's important that I play this to you because, frankly, we get more emails. Well, until Trump came along. We get more emails about the dinar than pretty much almost any other topic because many of you out there have invested in the dinar. Many of you know people who are invested in the dinar. Many of you write to us saying there are people who are saying you should invest in the dinar. What should we do? We can never tell you what you should do with your money. We can never tell you to invest here or there. We won't tell you. Because, frankly, there is something that you can do so that you can understand what you should do with your money. And guess what? That is go to your Heavenly Father. Pray to Him. Find out. Let Him be a part of your financial strategy and your financial planning. But I wanted to show this to you so you can understand that you have to be wise when it comes to the dinar, because Kim prophesied this May 17th, 2014. You'll hear it as he prophesies regarding the dinar, and you have to pay attention. If you want to know more, by the way, I just want to mention this. If you want to know more of what he prophesied, I encourage you to join the House of Destiny, because you get access to the broadcast, specifically May 17, 2014. He dealt with the dinar a lot in that broadcast, and you can actually see the broadcast and get the full picture. But I don't have time to show you everything he prophesied that day. But make note, May 17, 2014, it's in the House of Destiny. Join now so that you can see that broadcast. But I want to show you this specific part. Regarding the dinar, he mentions reevaluation, but importantly, he talks about corruption and how we should be wary. We need to be wise. Let's listen.
Regarding the dinar, everybody sitting watching now, some of you went, because you want to, all you want to hear is, when's it going to happen? When's the reevaluation going to take place? Many are out there that are calling themselves brokers, but taking advantage of your innocence in many of your lives. Hold on to everything, because there's a sign. Okay, this is the dinar, for those who want to know. By the way, it's a color that I prophesied about many years ago. That's something you should just go and delve into, because there are so many little things out there. Okay, so a lot of people want to make a lot of money quickly, and sometimes it happens and sometimes it doesn't. Most times it doesn't. But the key I found is to sow. Sow where there's life, sow where there is purpose, where God says something. And I found that brings prosperity. When I took the money into my hands, somebody had sent some to me, which we kept in a safe. But I took the money and I didn't have a good feeling. Just want you to know that. I didn't have a good feeling about it. When I say that, I say there's a lot of corruption. There are a lot of lies. There are a lot of brokers that are trying to milk you, as he said. And I felt to pray against that.
Kim prophesied about the dinar. He was holding up the dinar and he said those words. And that's just some of the words he said. I encourage you once again to go back to that broadcast, May 17, 2014. It's in our House of Destiny. If you're not a part of House of Destiny, join now. You know, we have two prophetic puzzle pieces, the one you just heard, and then another one I just read to you earlier. November 22nd, 2013, the Dow at 20,000 points. All this connects to a massive breakthrough with regard to the dinar. It's almost like there's two different opinions, so to speak, regarding the dinar. This is why it's vitally important that you gain understanding and wisdom that, frankly, only the Holy Spirit can give you. So I encourage you to seek closer to God and find out what His will is for your investment strategy. I want to mention this to you, why it's so vitally important to have a direct line of communication with God. Genesis 26 is the story of Isaac. And a famine had come up in the land, and specifically in verse 1 says, there was a famine in the land besides the first famine that was in the days of Abraham. And Isaac went to Abimelech, king of the Philistines, in Gerar. Then the Lord appeared to him and said, do not go down to Egypt. Live in the land of which I shall tell you. Dwell in this land, and I will be with you and bless you. For to you and your descendants I give all these lands, and I will perform the oath which I swore to Abraham your father. What an amazing, beautiful conversation that just took place there. Isaac in his desperate need. There's famine. It hasn't rained. It's drought-ridden land. And he's wanting to go, as many of us naturally wanted to do, go to a place where he can get the supply. But God intervenes and appears to him. What happens as a follow-up? In verse 12, it says, then Isaac sowed in that land that is drought-stricken. He sowed in that land and reaped in the same year a hundredfold. And the Lord blessed him. The man began to prosper and continued prospering until he became very prosperous. He wasn't just prosperous, he was very prosperous. He sowed in a drought-stricken land. I can only imagine how ridiculous he looked to his neighbors and to people watching him as this man begins to dig into the earth, drought-stricken earth, and begins to sow when there's famine all around. And the Bible says he reaped that same year a hundredfold and he became very prosperous. What's the key? It goes back to that earlier verse I read to you, that conversation that took place. Then the Lord appeared to him, Isaac, and said, do not go down to Egypt, live in this land in which I shall tell you, dwell in this land and I will bless you. What just happened? You see, Isaac got his investment strategy directly from the Lord. He was available to hear from God. And God spoke to him, said, you should do this. And Isaac obeyed, and he did it, and he prospered. What's my message to you? God cares about you. God wants to bless you, and you have an opportunity to go to him directly and hear from him. The question is, how bad do you want that? How bad do you want to go to him directly and wait until you hear from him? I encourage you to go to him because you will become very prosperous. Deuteronomy 8:18 says, and you shall remember the Lord your God, for it is he who gives you power to get wealth, that he may establish his covenant, which he swore to your fathers as it is this day. Remember the Lord your God, for it is he who gives you power to get wealth. That reminds me of another scripture in Acts when Jesus instructs his disciples after he rose again, and he said the following in Acts 1:8, but you shall receive power when the Holy Spirit has come upon you. You shall receive power when the Holy Spirit has come upon you. So yes, you can, with the Holy Spirit, find out what God wants you to do, and you can be very prosperous. Go get it. Get in God's face. He will speak to you. You will find me when you search for me with all of your heart. Go get it. Seek him. July 18, 2015, from the den, Kim had this prophetic word regarding the dinar. And this is what I'm trying to tell you. The dinar is so much more, I believe, than just the currency. It could be referring to a whole system change in the Middle East. Is it coincidence that this new president has come in his first week, 20,000, and the sign of rain, and we know about his agenda for the Middle East, how it's different than the previous administration? Quite possibly this is a much bigger picture. And there's going to be change in the Middle East. Systems will change in the Middle East. So what I want you to do is pay attention and find out where it is God wants you to prosper, because the window of opportunity is here. July 18th, 2015, from the den, Kim had this to say regarding financial systems and the dinar. Go.
Spirit of God is speaking now over the region of Iraq, over the region of Iran, over the regions of the Middle East and Southern Asia. The earth is shaken and shall shake again. But God said, I am speaking that I may release resources, and there will be a grave surrender that will take place in the months to come. I want to free you, every one of you, my people, to be able to stretch out their hand to the lonely, to the hungry, to the poor, and feed them and clothe them. This is my desire, says the Lord. Therefore, there shall be a break in the financial system in the Middle East, the dinar. And many shall say, why? Why now? But God said, when things seem at their worst, I shall bring it forth and I shall free them up. There shall be a prosperity in a place where you least expect it. The prayers of my people in Iran and the prayers of my Christian people that come forth from Iraq and from Palestine. Yes, Palestine. And even those regions, I will hear their prayers and I will do something marvelous and will affect this nation, says the Lord. You put your hand in the hand of Iran, I say to you, I will remove the hand of America out of the hand of Iran, says the Lord, and I will free up my people.
You can see there's such a bigger picture here. Systems changing, regions, changes in regions, and God intervening in a place where you least expect it. There shall be a prosperity in a place where you least expect it. Kim says, I want to free you, every one of you, my people, to be able to stretch out their hand to the lonely, to the hungry, to the poor, and feed them and clothe them. This is my desire, says the Lord. Therefore, there shall be a break in the financial system in the Middle East, the dinar. Systems are changing, folks. Things are changing. We have entered a new season. The calendar, the prophetic calendar has changed. Signs are happening everywhere. That should indicate to you God is on the move and you have to quickly get in rhythm because change is happening fast. But if you get in rhythm and be ahead of the curve, quite possibly, you will find where it is God wants you to sow into. Now, as Kim mentioned here, I want my people to stretch out their hand to the lonely, to the hungry, to the poor, and feed them and clothe them. And that's what we are able to do. Right House of Destiny, with your help, we are able to go and help people all around the earth, people in need, people who are devastatingly sad because of a tragedy that took place because of, for instance, a terror attack that took place in Israel. Guess what? With your help, we were able to provide support and help, financial aid, to families of terror victims in Israel. A recent terror attack took place, hideous terror attack, where soldiers were literally run over by a truck for no good reason, and we were there to help immediately through IFCJ. So, guess what? God wants to bless you so that you can be a blessing. You have an opportunity to bless. So, what I want you to do is consider sowing in to the House of Destiny so that you can bless those around the earth. And guess what? We're about to go boots on the ground in Israel, and we'll be providing you reports on how your sowing has literally blessed families in that nation. What I want to do is show you this beautiful report from Yael Eckstein. She heads, along with her father, IFCJ, and it was through IFCJ that you were able to help the terror victims. Watch this.
Shalom, my friends at the Kim Clements Center. I want to give a big thank you to all of the warriors and to the team at the Kim Clements Center, to Jane, to Miranda, to Sunil, to everybody there who has really continued on to carry on Kim's vision. Just yesterday, the Kim Clements Center announced that they're going to sponsor Victims of Terror, which is unreal. The comfort that they could give to the victims of terror in Israel. Just recently, there was an attack on the Jerusalem Promenade, where actually Kim stood overlooking the old city of Jerusalem, overlooking the Western Wall. And right there, there was a group of soldiers and a terrorist came and rammed his car into them. This happens almost daily, whether you hear about it or not. There are soldiers and civilians being targeted, and the Kim Clements Center is carrying on the vision. Jane is standing so strong in face of all of the hardships, in face of all of the sadness, to just bring light to the world. So thank you, Jane. Thank you, warriors, and God bless you.